Hey everybody, it's John. Welcome to the shop here in the great state of Texas. Today's a real brief video, going to show you how I built this drawbar. Now this drawbar here was made specifically for a Collet chuck that I bought off Banggood, and it had a metric thread on the back of it. It did not have the typical 3/8, so I had to make another drawbar. It was a really easy project, a rather interesting project, and I'll show you how I built that. And it is, there's no cut threads on here. This is a glued up assembly. Join me at the bench. I'll show you how I did that. Here's a little light sketch that I drew up here showing the different parts of this. What you're looking at here is just a piece of 3/4 inch hex stock. Now, this piece right here, the mandrel itself is made out of 1/2 inch drill rod. So it's just a cut-off piece of drill rod. Now, as I said, this collet chuck here has a metric thread. The thread is a 10 by 175, I think, or maybe it was a 12 by 175. Yes, it was a 12 by 175 thread. Now, my lathe will cut metric threads, but I got to do a bunch of gear changing to switch over to metric threads. So what I did, this part right here, which is the drill stem, if you look very closely, you'll be able to see a seam right there. What I did, I just bored a 1/4 inch hole about right up into that far inside this drill stem. It was a 1/4 inch hole, and then I bought a metric bolt, the 12 by 175, that was also about 3 inches long or so, and then I cut the bolt off, or I turned the bolt down, and you'll be able to see here, I turned it down with a 1/4 inch shaft on it. So what it is, the bolt shaft is sticking up inside there. Now, I Loctited that in, and then there's a brass pin, little 1/8 inch brass pin that I put through there. So that'll take the pulling effort, that'll hold all that in. Up here is just a straight turning job. This fits the spindle bore of the spindle on my lathe. This butts up against the spindle itself. So whenever you're in the lathe, you know, it's running like this inside your spindle. And this is just a little washer that I turned on. Now, I said, I think in the introduction, I didn't turn any threads at all. Actually, I did. I just threaded that half by, I think I had SAE threads because that's what I had set up. I just did an internal threading and an external threading and Loctited this nut on there. So this part right here spins, both the washer spins. This little washer right here is just a turn to a slip fit. Just so I can hold everything together on there, so I can hold the shoulder and the washer itself. So really there was only about 4 pieces, I think, or maybe 5. Let's see, this is the bolt, turned down with a 1/4 inch shaft. This is the drill rod, 1/4 inch bore, so I can insert the turned down shaft. It's got a little brass pin in it. Then there was a turning job here on the spinning doodad here that fits up inside the mandrel, and a washer. The whole job took maybe an hour, hour and a half to do. It works great. Well, as you can see, that's a very easy project, one that was quick, easy, took about an hour and a half to do, and very enjoyable and pleasurable to do out here in the shop. Before I close, I want to make a comment about a video that I did previous to this when I was reviewing a chuck that I got from Banggood. It was an ER25 collet chuck. I had previously bought a chuck from Banggood. They shipped it over. It was clearly defective. It had a run out of over 5 or 6 thousandths, which was very excessive. And it was, the nut was not machined correctly on it. Long story is, to make it a little shorter, Banggood refunded that 100%, and I then ordered another ER25 collet chuck, and that was the one I had in the previous video. And it had about a 2/1000th run out in it. I had a viewer email me or make a comment in that video that I may want to go back and check the dowel pin that was showing in that video. And sure enough, out of a drawer full of dowel pins, I pulled out the one that was not running true. When I went back and put another dowel pin, a straight one in there, I was then showing a run out of less than 2/10. That's 2/10 of 1/1000. So the run out was well within the specs on that collet chuck. Now I've left that video back up because, with the exception of that dial indicator being out, everything else was correct in that video. And I did go back and annotate that video, notating that I had an incorrect dowel pin in there. And by the way, thanks, Eddie. I put a link to your channel in the comments down below. Guys, until we see you in the shop next time, this is John from one side of a two-car garage on the Upper East Side of Texas. We'll see you in the shop.